bought something off of Craigslist. Another nice Craigslist find. I'm hoping that it'll heat my shop. It's an old, actually can't really see much now. Snow. Oops, sorry, out of the camera once again. I forgot to put the lids on. I didn't think it was gonna snow. But straps out of there. It's an old cook stove. And it's got the two round discs with the and that center piece. And you just flip up, stoke the fire. I'll have to make an oval out of the the chimney exhaust. But that's fine. Heavy bastard. Gotta be 500 pounds. Cast iron and all that fire brick and more cast iron and whew, lifted it into the truck by myself. I was feeling it the next day. I actually got this yesterday and I just said to hell with it. I ain't taking this off until tomorrow. I need some recuperation time. Alright, let me untie this and I'll set up the tripod and lift this thing out of my truck. And hey, who knows, you might get some good video. You can watch me lying in my driveway, choking and wheezing for breath as the 500 pound cook stove lies on my chest. Look at him die, you'll all say. And I'll just say hey. Anyway, I'll be right back. Here we go. I should be fine as long as my feet don't slip. Ouch. Well, she's down. Well, here's my little stove. Did a little bit of work to it. I might just leave this door off, or I can put it back if I really need to, but I think that it'll actually heat up better. I think I'm fogging up or something. I don't know. Yeah, so that's the ash bin. And then these, you get a little crank handle, and these turn like little rotisseries in there, which helps drop the ash, breaks it up into smaller pieces, drops it down. One of these buggers. Let's see. I had, hold on a sec, let me track something down here. Oh, there it is. They were using this. It was just a straight, it's basically a damper handle for inside the pipe. You'll have like a damper and you can open and close it. So I put a little bend on the end, ground down the end. Now it's a lot easier to remove these. Oh my god, this came with a drill. Let's see. Let's get this out of the way. Crunch, crunch. Me and my great camera work. Okay. So those are the little rotisseries. Let me get my drill out so I don't grind it. And yeah, you'll turn it. And they'll just kind of break down the ashes a bit. Scrape, I guess it scrapes the wood, I think. And that just keeps you down to good burning wood. And you just turn them every once in a while. Get good ashes down there. So what I did here, this actually came with it as well, but it was just a straight pipe, so I split it and drilled some holes. Down here is a little cast iron lip that would fit whatever one would actually custom fit this, but good luck trying to find parts for this, I'm sure. So I drilled some holes, put some screws in, molded it along, so it closes up fairly well there. And then I used the collar, tap the collar down, it seals this up a little better. I'll maybe use that metal foil tape for furnaces, or I might get some of that, I think there's some sort of caulking compound that you use for fireplaces and stuff. I'll look around. Yeah, so I tap the collar down to tighten that up, and then I'll get a piece to fit the collar to slide over, cut this to whatever I need, because I don't really need that, and put a damper in here. So I can control the temperature comes in, and away we go. So that worked out pretty good, actually. Except I had one screw break there, so I had to go over a notch. But yeah, $20. Once again, I think I scored pretty darn good. Oops. Now, hopefully this puppy will throw out the heat I need. I gotta imagine it will, especially with the front off. But, well, I might put the thing on. I'll have to see, because I might even take these sidewalls off as well and just leave it as the cast iron. That's probably what I'll do. It'll look ugly as hell, but it'll throw the heat. Then I got a little squirrel fan that I can attach and throw the heat this away. And I can even get one of them little econo fan things that you can sit on top and then the heat makes them blow. Or if I want to be real cheap, I'll just put one of my fans that I already have behind it and just have it blow it around a bit. Anyway, hopefully this will do the job. I've already got, well, I've got it covered up there so the bees wouldn't come in, but I got it double insulated through that metal door. So all I need to do is get a couple pieces of this cheap ass piping, and I'm good to go. The hell with it. I was going to get that stainless steel stuff, but the double. But you know what? When I think back to shops that I've had a barrel with a rusty pipe going out through a sheet metal hole in the window, and I never burned the place down, this will be just fine. I like it. My body doesn't, though. It's screaming. It's going, "What did you do to me?"